How does somebody go through so many difficulties and still keep progressing? It is said, what is the difference between those who are successes and those who are failures? Those who succeeded, they failed 10 times, but they continued and succeeded in the 11th attempt. Those who are failures gave up after 5 defeats. I like to give the example of Mr. Soichiro Honda, the founder of the worldwide Honda automobile empire. He was born in Japan, not with the proverbial golden spoon in his mouth. Rather, he was born in a lower middle class family. But he had this inspiration burning in him to do something that would make a difference. So he went to engineering school. He designed a prototype for piston rings. And he went and presented it to Toyota as a superior design. They rejected it. He became the laughing stock of his colleagues. However, he was inspired. He said, if they wish to laugh, let them laugh. He made another design, and this time he presented it, it got selected. So Toyota gave him an order and they extended him the capital to set up his factory for piston rings. So when he got his factory all done, there was an earthquake. The factory collapsed. He said, never mind, we will make it again. Second time he was about to make it, Japan entered into the Second World War and cement became in short supply. He said, never mind. He found a new way to make cement, and with the help of that he set up his factory. However, by that time, America entered the war and they bombed his factory as they were bombing Japan. So his factory went down once again. He was still inspired. He said, nevertheless, he was unstoppable. So in those days, planes were different. Once the fuel was used to lighten the plane, they would throw the gasoline tank. So the ground was strewn with all these gasoline tanks of the American bomber planes. He said, let's use these gasoline tanks to make the factory again. He called them gifts from Mr. Truman. And he set up his factory for the third time. By then, Japan had lost the war. And fuel was now in short supply. People didn't have the fuel to drive Toyota cars. So what will Toyota manufacture, and why will they use his piston rings? His factory was ready, but there was now no orders for piston rings. What to do? He was riding his bicycle. One day he got the brain wave. He set a motor into the bicycle. It was the first motorcycle. When he drove around the neighborhood, his friends looked at it and said, can you do that for me as well? Now when he made about 20 motorcycles for the neighborhood people, he thought he had a marketable idea. Now he didn't have the money to produce motorcycles. But look, his inspiration says no difficulty is too big. He got a list of 8,000 bicycle stockists of Japan. And he hand wrote notes to 5,000 of them. 1,800 responded, extending a little bit of capital. With the help of that, he set up his motorcycle factory. The first contraption he made, the first motorcycle, was very big and it was a failure. So he said, never mind, I'll try once again. He made a smaller model. It was called the Super Cub. And it was an immediate success. After that, there was no looking back. In his time, Honda Corporation employed 100,000 people worldwide, and now it has gone even beyond. So then this key ingredient for success is the inspiration, the enthusiasm. This quality of inspiration is also the key ingredient for success on the spiritual journey of life transformation, of making yourself a better person. If you are inspired, you will get difficulties, you will keep surmounting them. If you are not inspired, a little obstacle will seem like a mountain. So that inspiration is so important. That is why in the Bible, Jesus told his followers, be either hot or cold. If you are lukewarm, I will spit you out. If you are lukewarm, you will not succeed in this journey. Maharshi Patanjali, in his Yoga Sutras, he said, there are three levels of sadhaks or spiritual aspirants. One is the mridu. Mridu is the chalta hai variety. I'll try, oh, theek hai, hua, nahi hua. And there the madhya. They say, you know, do it properly. And there's the vishesha, who say if anything is worth doing at all, it is worth doing well. Give it your best shot. So he says, those are the kind of people who succeed on this journey.
I just have one word for my experience of this retreat, and it's priceless.
I think it's been one of the best and one of the most amazing JKYog retreats ever.